Welcome to the world of data. So data today is growing faster than ever before, which makes it important for us to know the basics of the domain like data science, big data, and data analytics. So most of the people are actually being confused amongst these terms. So in this session, I'll talk about the distinction between data science, big data, and data analytics. Based on what is it, where is it used, we'll also look at the roles and responsibilities to become professionals in the field, with their skills and the salary prospects in each field. And then we'll take the example of Amazon to see their respective job responsibilities. So let's begin with understanding the basic concepts of these. So big data is huge volumes of data that can be of structured, semi-structured, and unstructured. And they are generated in multi-terabytes through various digital channels like mobile, internet, and social media, etc. And these are not able to be processed using traditional applications. So now, unlike traditional technologies like RDBMS, big data actually processes large volume of data at a faster pace and also provides you an opportunity to store the data with different tools, technologies, and methodology. Now, big data solutions actually provide the techniques to capture, store, and analyze, even search the data in seconds, that make it easy to find insights and relationships for innovation and competitive gain. So with suitable analytics, big data can be used to determine the causes of business failure, cost reduction, time saving, better decision making, and new product creation. So individuals with knowledge of big data are referred to as big data specialists. And hence, big data specialists will have expertise in, let's say, Hadoop, MapReduce, Spark, NoSQL, and DB tools like HBase, Cassandra, and MongoDB, etc. So data science actually tackles big data to extract information. So it's a field which is embracing all that is associated with the structured and unstructured data, starting with preparing, cleansing, analyzing, and deriving useful insights. And again, it's a combination of mathematics, statistics, intelligent data capture, programming, etc. So in a nutshell, it's a combination of several techniques and processes working on big chunks of data to gain knowledgeable business insights. So they would initially gather data sets from distinct disciplines and then compile it. And after compilation, they apply predictive analysis, machine learning, and sentiment analysis. So finally, data scientists would actually extract some useful information from it. Now, data scientists understand data in a business view and provide accurate prediction and charges for the same, and thus preventing a business person from future loss. So data scientists will have expertise in, let's say, statistics, logistics and linear regression, differential and integral calculus, among other mathematical techniques. Now you could also use tools like R, Python, SAS, SQL, Tableau, and so on. So most of us are of the opinion that both data science and data analytics are similar, which is not the case. Yes, they both actually differ at some minute point, and that can be noticed through deep concentration. Now, data analytics is the fundamental level of data science, and you need to know this. So data analytics makes use of data mining and techniques and tools to discover patterns in the analyzed data set. So here, we actually are mainly looking into the historical data from a completely modern perspective and applying methodologies to find a better solution. Now, not only this, but data analytics would also predict the upcoming opportunities which company can exploit. So data science actually utilizes data analytics to provide strategic and actionable insights. So here, data analyst plays a major role. So he'll have expertise in, let's say, our statistical computing, data mining techniques, data visualization, and Python programming. Now we'll look at some of the applications of each. So the retail industry, they also use big data to remain in the retail business and staying competitive. So the important key here is to understand and serve the customer better. So this would actually require proper analysis of all the sources of different data, just like data from customer transaction, weblogs, loyalty program data, social media data, and so on. And this can be easily done with big data. Now we all know that telecommunication service providers have priorities of retaining customers, gaining new ones, and expanding the current customer bases. Now, so in order to do this, the act of combining and analyzing tons of customer and machine-generated data created on a daily basis can be done with big data. Now, even big financial service providing firms, just like retail banks, credit card companies, insurance firms, venture funds, etc., they also make use of big data for their financial services. So the major challenge experienced by all of them is the large amount of multi-structured data embedded in multiple different systems. And now this can only be taken care of by big data. So big data is actually used in various ways, such as fraud analytics, customer analytics, operational analytics, and compliance analytics. Now, while data science has its own hires, one of the most common application is recommender systems. Yes. So these systems add so much to user experience and also make it easy for users to find relevant recommendations and choices of their interest. Now, it can be anything like relevant job postings, movies of interest, suggested videos, Facebook friends, or people who bought this also bought this, etc. So several companies actually are using this recommender systems for promoting their suggestions and products according to the user's interest and relevance of information and demands. So recommendations always depend upon the previous search result of users. Now another one is internet search. So here, many search engines use data science algorithms to deliver the best results in just a split of second. And then the whole digital marketing ecosystem makes use of data science algorithm. And that is the major reason why digital ads get higher CTR than the conventional forms of advertisements. And let me tell you guys that data science applications are not limited to these. Yes, it can be implemented on web development, e-commerce, finance, telecom, etc. Now, on the other hand, data analytics for healthcare. Let's check it out. So the major challenge today hospitals are facing is the cost pressure that needs to be overcome to treat their patients effectively. And here, machine and instrument data is used increasingly for tracking and optimizing treatment. Then in the terms of gaming. So the advantage analytics plays a major role over here, including collection of data in order to optimize and spend across games. So companies which are developing these games get a good insight into likes, dislikes, and the relationships with their users. And then let's suppose travel industry. So again, data analytics is able to optimize the buying experience through the mobile and the social media. Travel sites can gain insights into the customer's desires and preferences. So products can actually be upsold by correlating the current sales to the subsequent increase in browsing habit. And then personalized travel recommendations can also be delivered by data analytics based on social media data. Now let us look at some of the important roles and responsibilities in each area. So a big data specialist is a professional who ensures uninterrupted flow of data between servers and applications. So they actually work on implementing complex big data projects with a focus on collecting, parsing, managing, analyzing, and visualizing larger sets of data to turn information into insights, right? So they are actually, or they should be able to decide on the needed hardware and software designs as well. Now the big data engineer should be able to develop prototypes and proof of concepts for the selected solutions. Whereas a data scientist is a professional who uses their technical and analytical capabilities to extract meaningful insight from data. So they would actually understand data from a business point of view and would also be in charge of making predictions to help businesses take accurate decisions. So data scientists come with a solid foundation of computer applications, modeling, statistics, and math. So they are again efficient in picking the right problems, which will add again value to the organization after resolving it. And then if I talk about data analysts, then they also play a major role in data science. So they perform a variety of tasks related to collecting, organizing data, and obtaining statistical information out of them. So they are also responsible to present the data in form of charts, graphs, and tables, and then use the same to build relational databases for the organization. Now we look at some of the skill sets that are required to be a professional in this area. So if you plan or if you are planning to be a professional in big data, then you should have mathematics and statistical skills. So that's very necessary for all areas of data, which includes big data, data science, and data analytics. After all, this is where it all begins, right? And then you also need to have analytical skills. So that is the ability to make meaning out of tons of data. And then, as computers are the engines that power everyday data strategy, and hence, computer science or computer science skill is the most important for a big data professional. And you also need to be able to creatively put new methods together for gathering, interpreting, and analyzing data. And after that, if you want to be a data scientist, then you must be able to work with unstructured data, which is very important, and irrespective of where it comes from, whether it's from audio, social media, or video feeds. And then you should also need to have good knowledge of Hadoop platform. And with that, it is also an added advantage if you know coding in Python. Because Python is known to be the most common coding language used in data science, apart from Perl, Java, C, C++, etc. Now you can also have deep knowledge of R or SAS, because R programming is another preferable programming language in data science. And let me tell you guys that although Hadoop and NoSQL are major parts of data science, but again, knowing how to write and execute complex queries in SQL is again preferable. And then you'll need to know business skills to get a good understanding of various business objectives, which pushes the business to grow along with its profit. And if you want to become a data analyst, then you need to have a very good knowledge of programming languages such as Python and R, because they are really important in this field. And then as an aspiring data analyst, statistical skills and mathematics is the much needed, yes. And again, to be a data analyst, you need to map out and convert raw data into another format. That will make it more convenient for consumption. And then good communication and data visualization skills, again, is a must require, and you must have data intuition, which means you need to think and reason like a data analyst. So these were a sort of prerequisites that you actually should have if you want to build your career into this respective domains. And then, the work profiles of all the three are entirely different, yes, which makes their salaries to vary from one another as well. So let's discuss that now. So data science is booming like anything, and that is why it makes data science to stand up at the top when it comes to salary, that is around $122,000 per year. Now next are the big data specialists, who can earn around $115,000 per year, followed by the data analyst with an annual income of $92,000 per year. Now we have come to a point where we are going to discuss an example of Amazon to understand how each of them are related and providing its benefits. So let's begin with big data. So here, the huge amount of unstructured data is being generated from various sources. Now, which is difficult to process through traditional databases, right? So due to this, a big data professional creates an environment using various big data ecosystem tools to store and process data effectively and timely. Now let's see what is the role of data scientist in Amazon example. So here, we are going to talk about how Amazon optimizes its business using data science. So data scientist is the one who will be able to drive sales with intelligent product recommendations. And then he'll also predict the future revenue that each customer will bring to your business in a given period. And also they would predict how often they are likely to make purchase and the average value of each purchase with customer lifetime value modeling. Now they would also discover which customers are likely to churn, that is to say, acquiring new customers as well as maintaining relationship with existing ones. Now, data scientist usually creates a model to automatically extract useful information from reviews. And with this information, Amazon can efficiently maximize user satisfaction by prioritizing product updates that will have the greatest positive impact. Now, we'll see what's the role of data analyst in Amazon example. So here, data analyst is actually responsible for supply chain management, which includes managing data for products right from warehouse to the customer. So Amazon also uses data extensively to manage inventory. Also, it helps to optimize transportation and pricing of delivery. Now, data analyst will also be involved in user experience analytics, mainly includes how is product search across portfolio, or what decides the ranking order of products for a particular search, or what is the best landing page for a customer coming from a Facebook, etc. Then data analyst is also responsible for, let's say, identifying merchant customer fraud detection. So this is how Amazon leverages data science, big data, and data analytics to make customer experience a more delightful one. Now that we know the difference between the three, so which one do you think is the most suitable for you? Well, the option is for you. You can simply decide whether you can make your career in data science or big data or data analytics. So Intellipaat here has dozens of data science, big data and data analytics course online, including our integrated program in big data and data science. So if you would like to become an expert in data science or big data, you can check out our master certification training courses, which are Big Data Data Science Certification Master Course and Data Science Master Course and Big Data Architect Master Course. And with this, we come to the end of this video. I really hope that by now you must have got a clear idea and a distinction between all these terms, and you must have got what is actually the suitable career that can be for you. So thank you so much, friends, for giving us your precious time. If you have any query, feel free to contact us anytime. I hope the video was informative for you. Please like the video, and if you have any doubts, comment below. We shall respond to it at the earliest. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more detailed information, visit our website now. Have a great day and career ahead.